need to do first is come up with a better way to add stuff without having to actually write it all down and add it up. So that's where sigma notation comes in. So what this is a shorthand for writing down that you're going to add up a whole bunch of stuff. But you have to have a pattern. There has to be a pattern between all the stuff you're going to add up. And what it is, it's saying this is the sigma right here. It's a Greek letter S, stands for sum. And you put a formula right inside of it, right? And this is a formula that gives you the terms you want to add up. And you know there's a variable here. This variable is an I. That's your variable. It works like an X, but in sigma notation, we actually call it an index instead of a variable. And what you do is you start with whatever number's on the bottom. So I'm running out of colors. Let's pick green. This number on the bottom, you want to start with that. And you're going to plug in 1 to your function, plug in 2, plug in 3, plug in 4, plug in 5 to your formula until you get to the number on top. So that's the stopping number. And you're going to take all those things that you just made and you want to add them all up. And when you do that, you're going to get one big number and that's your answer. Right? I acknowledge that that was very confusing, so let's do an example. All right, say it says I goes from 4 to 9 of I squared. What does that mean? That means you start with a 4. You put that in for I squared, so you get 4 squared. Then you add to that 5 squared, go up by 1 every time. 6 squared, 7 squared, when do I stop? At 9. 8 squared, 9 squared. I stop when I get to the number on top. And if I got my calculator out and I added up all those numbers, that would be the answer. That's all well and good, but it only really helps us if this is going to give us a shortcut. And there's not a shortcut for everything, but there is a shortcut for 4 specific formulas. So if you start at 1 and you stop at n, and you're just adding up the number 1 over and over again, we want to be able to jump straight to the answer without having to do it. So for this one, let me show you where it comes from. Sum I goes from 1 to n of 1. So what happens when you plug I equals 1 into that formula? You get 1. What do you get when you plug in 2? 1. When you plug in 3, you get 1. When you plug in 4, you get 1. If you're confused, think of this as the function f of I equals 1, no matter what you put in for 1. Right? No matter what you put in for I, you're going to get 1. So we do this. Everything we put in gives us 1. How many 1s do we have? N. So what's the answer to this? N. Good. You add up 1 n times, you're going to get n. So we won't ever have to do that again. From now on, if you see I goes from 1 to n of 1, you just know it's n. Now, the other ones are a lot harder to come up with, so I'm just going to give you the answers. If you have I goes from 1 to n of I, so that means somebody's asking you to add up 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus, and you stop when you get to n. Somebody asks you to do that. The answer is n times n plus 1 over 2. If you're adding up I squared, so that's like 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared, plus all the way up to n squared, that answer is going to be n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6. And if it's I cubed, it's the same as I, n times n plus 1 over 2, but then you take your answer and you square it. So you need to memorize those. Memorize those 4 formulas. They're also in your book. But the good news is, if somebody asks you to add from 1 to 1,000 of I squared, well, let's do it. I'm going to ask you to add I goes from 1 to 1,000 of I squared. What are you going to get? Well, the formula says n. What's n in this case? 1,000. So n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1, so that'd be 2,001, all over 6. So whatever that number is, that's the answer. So, well, that's all well and good if we just happen to be adding up those 4 things. But usually, our area equation, you know, that's what we're going to be adding up, right, is all these area equations. They're more than just, you know, I squared. So we need some more simplification rules. One of them is that you can pull out a constant. So if somebody asks you to add up 2i, that's the same as adding up 2 times I. And then the other one is that you can break things apart over addition and subtraction. So if somebody asks you to add up I plus I squared, you can just add up I and then add up I squared. Same thing if it was I minus I squared. All right, so say you're supposed to add up I goes from 1 to 20 of 3k cubed plus 6k. Using these rules we just talked about, what's the first thing you should do? Separate it over the addition. So that would be I goes from 1 to 20 of 3k cubed plus a new sum, I goes from 1 to 20 of 6k. Good. All right, then what? Pull those constants out. So 3 times the sum, I goes from 1 to 20, k cubed, plus 6, sum k goes from 1 to 20 of k. All right. So now notice that k going from 1 to 20 of k cubed and k going from 1 to 20 of k, those match up with formulas that we have. Right? They make you think of, you know, this k goes from 1 to 20 of k is making me think of I goes from 1 to n of I. Right? And I know that that ought to be n times n plus 1 over 2. So in this case, does it matter that it's k's instead of i's? No, not at all. And so all I want to do then is replace that n with a 20. So I'm going to get 6 times 20 times 21 over 2. And then over here I use the formula for k cubed. And I get 20 times 21 over 2 again, but this time squared.